Here's the maths teacher we all wish we'd had. Eddie Wu is breathing new life into learning. He was named the 2018 Local Hero at the Australian of the Year Awards, and he was listed in the world's top 10 teachers.
Now, students all over the globe can't get enough of his YouTube clips that make maths fun and interesting, but Eddie's work has also tempted teachers to do things a bit more creatively in the classroom as well.
I get to touch the fabric of the universe when I understand what mathematics is.
Eddie Wu is bringing the magic and wonder back to mathematics. He began posting clips of lessons online so a sick student wasn't left behind. And before he knew it, he was YouTube, or rather, WooTube sensation, inspiring learners across the world.
What I love is that this enables students to learn on their own terms. New Zealand, 50,000. Every African nation. Greenland, 70 views. That's great. That place is mostly ice. I'm amazed.
The internet provided a window into Mr. Wu's classroom, and his passion for maths has multiplied.
I teach about 800 hours over the school year, but my YouTube videos have been watched for over 90 million minutes. That's more than I could teach in not just my lifetime, like several copies of my lifetime.
Eddie says he's not a maths maverick. What's most important is engaging students to ensure they reach that moment of understanding.
Like this, because remember, the length is X, right? Those little wins are really powerful because each one of them contributes a very difficult to quantify, but centrally important change to the way we think of ourselves as learners.
And Eddie Wu joins us now live. I should say Mr. Wu, should I?
Eddie is fine.
It's so lovely to see you. Welcome.
Thank you for having
you
me.
You are a complete rock star to kids and to adults alike. What is it? Did you set out to do things differently to other teachers, or that's just who you are?
Yeah, look, I would love to claim that there was some grand plan and strategy behind it, but I kind of think it's just a bit about, as a mathematics teacher, it's kind of 10% knowing your mathematics, but then 90% being a human being, having a sense of humour and letting that personality flow through what you want to teach and learn.
But what do you say when people say, I'm not a maths person, or particularly to parents who have kids that just don't get maths? Sort of almost scared of doing maths. How do you break that down?
Well, that's actually so important to identify, because I know that, you know, there's this huge anxiety that comes over a lot of people when numbers come up, when equations sort of appear. You're like, I'll do anything I can to avoid it. Yeah. I think what's really important there is, I mean, we've learned already with young kids, we should read with them. It doesn't matter if we were no literary expert, but just the positive modeling of reading, something we can enjoy. It's something we can do together. Doing something like that mathematically, you know, playing board games with our kids and having fun with that, paying attention to the mathematics that's around us and just saying, hey, look at that, it's interesting. I don't need to be an expert on it to appreciate it and help you also come to terms with it. That's really important.
There's so much pressure on kids these days and on adults and on parents. What do you think as a teacher of like tutoring outside of school, I guess particularly with maths, this is where a lot of parents try and get their kids into after school. Is that overloading them or is that helpful?
Yeah, look, I totally get it. I mean, as a parent myself, NAPLAN results came in the mail not that long ago. And I feel that pressure culturally can be very dangerous. I want people to think it's important, mathematics matters. But when I think about what kids are doing after school, how many activities they've got, and what we're sort of putting on them emotionally, I think it's just important to let them be kids and not to have them feel like you're under pressure to perform and get these results in tests. That's not the thing that matters most.
See, I think the block with maths is too logical for a lot of our brains, because it is a really odd logical thing. You were saying, as parents, let's share and build interest around. That's what your book's about, isn't it?
Yes, 100%.
For kids and also parents to go, you can do it together. Tell us about the book.
Yeah, no, you're exactly right. And this book that we put together, it's all about having people participate in mathematics together and view that it doesn't have to be intimidating. Anyone can pick it up. It's very visual and inviting. And there are lots of activities, games you can play together with your kid that walk
you through.
Give us
an example of a game.
Okay, sure. So there are lots of little things you can do with just a deck of cards. You know, I grew up with my 52, you know, diamonds, clubs, hearts, spades, which a lot of kids, they're playing Candy Crush or Minecraft and forget there's this wonderfully simple object, if you're concerned about screen time, that actually has perfect mathematical patterns in it. You can play lots of games, which again, the book talks you through, that are fun and help you observe patterns around you.
We love it. Gee, I wish you'd been around in my day. I would have enjoyed that so much more. Eddie, it was lovely to see you. Good luck with the book. It's out right now. Check it out.